Hey guys, hope you're having a wonderful day. So you have a brand new gaming mouse with lots of buttons and settings, and you're a Linux user, and you want to set up your new shiny mouse. But the software needed to set up all its features is not made for Linux, but only for Windows? Well, this video might be for you then, so stay and find out. So as I said, the problem with gaming, or any other fancy mouse on Linux, is that the software needed to set up all its features is not made for Linux, but only for Windows. So you're left without a way to set up your sensor sensitivity or extra button functions. And with gaming on Linux getting better and better with Proton, this can be a problem for many new users. But don't worry, as always, open source projects come to the rescue. There is this great little software called Piper, as in Pied Piper, that can set up many modern mice and unlock their full potential. So let me show you how to set it up and use it. First, we need to go to their Git page. I'll put a link in the description. So this is their Git. Here we can see a bit about the project. Some screenshots too, but the most important thing we need to check on here is the mouse support list. If your mouse is on this list, you're set. We get to the support list by clicking on here. It takes us to this list with all supported mice. So try to find yours here. Lots of Logitech mice are supported. Also, don't be confused if you notice this support list belongs to another project called libratbagd. Libratbagd is a command line program that Piper allows you to use through its GUI, so you don't have to deal with command lines. Piper does everything for you. So if you found your mouse on this list, let's set it up. First, we need to click on this link under the Installing Piper section. Here we can see a list of commands used to install Piper on different distros. Pick the one you need. The rest is the same. I am using Linux Mint, which is a Ubuntu-based, so I will pick Ubuntu. If you have any other distro based on Ubuntu, like PopOS, do the same. If not, just pick your distro. Let me just open up the terminal and clean up the screen a bit. And now we need to copy the command we need into our terminal and press Enter. When it asks if we are sure we want to install it, press Y. And now we need to wait a bit so everything gets downloaded and installed. It doesn't take too long. It's not that big of a program. Okay, great, it's done. Piper is installed. Now we can close out of all this and set up our mouse. Just let me close down all this. And now we need to go to the Start menu and find Piper. And it works. Now comes the fun part. Let's make it full screen. Okay, here we see the simplified image of our mouse. I am using the G604. It has six side buttons, as we can see on the image. One thing I want to mention first is that everything we change in Piper is saved on the mouse. So everything set here will stay the same across all devices and operating systems you use because it's saved in the mouse itself and not on your computer. First, we can set up the sensor sensitivity. We have five profiles we can save for quick access. We click on them, and then click Apply to activate them. Here I activated a 250 dpi profile, really low and slow one. And as you can see, my mouse is moving way slower now. Let's change it. Let's use 800 dpi. Okay, it's better. 8000 dpi now. That's what I usually use. As you can see, now it's way faster. It's really easy to change dpi values with Piper. Also, we're not stuck with five default values. We can set any value we want in any profile with a slide. Here I set it to the maximum of 25,500 dpi for my mouse. That's way too sensitive, but let's try it. It works, and my mouse feels like it's moving on ice. Let's put it back to 8,000. Next, we can set up the pulling rate for our mouse. That's the number of times your mouse tells "I am here" to the computer. The higher your pulling rate is, the more sensitive and less laggy your mouse is. But if it's wireless, as mine is, it also uses more battery. I just set my pulling rate to the maximum, and you should probably do the same. Okay, so if we go over here on the Buttons tab, we can set up all our mouse buttons. This, of course, depends on your mouse, and what buttons it allows you to change the function of. But this are the buttons my mouse allows me to change the function of. So basically, all of them. The picture makes this process really intuitive. Just find the button you want to change and click in its field. And then you get all the functions that button can do. It's a long list, and you can probably find what you're looking for. One really cool feature here is a macro. Since everything is saved on the mouse, It depends on your mouse if macros work and how many buttons macros support. But if it does, you can click on this option. Then press the key combo you want to use and save it. And then whenever you click that button, that key combo gets executed. You just need to be detailed. I want to put Alt plus G macro on this button. So I press the Alt down, then G up and down. And then I let go of the Alt key, so it records the Alt up. And now the macro is done. Last tab we can use is LED lighting. My mouse doesn't have any LED lights, so I don't have any options here. But if your mouse supports LED lights, here you can set them up. And that are the basics of Piper. There are a few more advanced options like profiles and directly using libratbagd from the terminal. I will probably make a video about that later. But for now, this is enough for you to set up your gaming mouse and use its full feature set. And that's it. Play around with the settings. See what works for you. I hope this helped you set up your mouse. Thanks for watching and happy tinkering.